I'm happy to speak to you today here at the Appleton Space Conference with a focus on utilization of space for a safer and greener future. And you'll see in the little presentation, the little walkthrough I'll provide you, that there are a number of topics where we are in fact already active, and we will, as we call it now, accelerate further for the use of space. Space has key technologies in a number of innovative areas and applications that includes green and disruptive solutions. And this is contributing to national objectives and international objectives in collaboration and trade. We see there's a clear link between green and economical benefit. Maybe a few words on an overview on ECSAT, the center at Harville, the ESA center in the UK. It is a window into a number of markets, national and global. It's enabling the UK national space programs in a number of disciplines. So it's a multidisciplinary approach. And we believe it brings an additional international dimension to these programs. Our partnership and collaboration, this philosophy is key in what we are doing. We do this through programs, through hubs, and I'll come to an example in a minute. We work with partners in the neighborhood as RAL Space, UKRI, STFC, UKSA on the Harville campus to boost the space sector as a whole through knowledge exchange, and that is with academia, with the public, and important also with private partners. In fact, many of the activities we are doing are in public-private partnership, including co-financing, and we're working very close to the market, maybe the program, the telecommunications program and integrated applications being the closest to a market situation. To give you a recent example, we launched an autonomous shuttle service recently at ECSAT that is integrating 5G mobility networks, connectivity solutions or terrestrial solutions with satellite telecommunications, so space-based connectivity. The so-called Darwin Autonomous Shuttle, which is made by Navya and insured by Aviva, is an autonomous vehicle with no steering wheel or mirrors. The shuttle service is supported by ESA, by the UKSA, the Harville Science Campus, STFC, Virgin Media O2, and Hispasat. You see, there is quite a significant partnership here between public participants and the private side and operators. It adds the shuttle to an existing ESA-supported effort to Harville to showcase the potential of space-enabled solutions and telecommunication solutions. We believe it is important in a growing digital economy to ensure that space finds its right place, and it has much value to add in a strongly increasing market. As studies show that connected cars, if we want to take this as an example, will lead to an estimate of 260,000 fewer accidents. It will save 11,000 lives, and by 2025 reduce CO2 emissions by 400,000 tons. So this is really what we call smart mobility, using information and connectivity to drive smarter, be more efficient in energy consumption, routing, avoiding traffic jams and the likes. So there is an immediate direct impact, I repeat, in terms of accidents, in terms of safety and saving lives, and in a true effort to decarbonize and reduce CO2. These projects are supported by our ECSAT-based state-of-the-art Business Innovation Center for Next Generation Connectivity. And we call this the 5G-6G hub. I made reference to that earlier. This is a concept that really is aggregating expertise around ECSAT on the topic for mobility solutions, terrestrial and space integrated. So this is utilizing the powers of 5G, 6G, the Internet of Things, to showcase and test applications. And this will benefit the seamless integration of satellite and terrestrial networks. The space-based solutions include applications which range from remote education to telemedicine to environmental monitoring. And you see that connectivity solutions like today applied in our setting here, they are based in connectivity in many cases, in particular in remote areas, space connectivity is an essential element. I would like to focus in on what we call accelerators. It's a new ambition on agency level, which has as an objective to accelerate the use of space in a broader context of space technologies in businesses and institutions in Europe. We believe this is a way forward also to provide further connectivity to Europe. The ESA Council of Ministers just very recently adopted a resolution to accelerate the use of space in Europe and to tackle the urgent and unprecedented societal, economic, and security challenges faced by Europe and its citizens. Now, this is achieved through three accelerators. So it's three distinct headings and lines of activities that we are preparing as we speak. And the number one, and it is the number one in priority today, is space for a green future. To use advanced space data, science and technology for sustainable life on Earth, including the development of digital twins of our planet, to support society and decision makers to reach carbon neutrality by 2050. Maybe to zoom into that topic for a moment, this is about Earth observation, monitoring information on the planet. It is about a digital twin to simulate with that data and predict certain scenarios, what if scenarios into the future to better estimate the impact of the change and crisis we are facing on the climate front. In addition to that, we believe that beyond the monitoring and the simulation, we in fact can come with smart solutions, sustainable mobility solutions to help reduce the carbon footprint. And the shuttle example I gave previously is just a very first step in this. So this is for the first accelerator. I repeat, this is space for a green future. The second accelerator is called Rapid and Resilience Crisis Response. This is really for enabling security stakeholders to ensure rapid provision of information, hence allowing quick response to climate-induced and related and other crises that Europe is facing. This is about making sure that we have space assets, which can be, again, monitoring system, Earth observation systems, but also connectivity solutions in space, artificial intelligence, edge computing, processing in space, a cognitive system, if you like, that will act as a whole to make sure that in case of crisis and also prior to crisis in terms of anticipating, the right information is available at the right time and in a timely fashion. That is something that exists in different versions and elements today, but we would really like to bring this forward to be able to act a crisis more effectively. We've seen examples in Germany with the floods and with Greece in wildfires this summer. And we know there are numerous of these events that are increasing as we go ahead. So this is number two of the accelerators. I repeat, rapid and resilience crisis response. The third accelerator is related to the protection of the space assets. So all the elements and infrastructure we will put in space that are in space, as you may know, they are increasingly faced with a situation where space is getting populated, if you want. We have a high number of new launches in new orbits and new space infrastructures and systems, in particular connectivity constellations that populate the space. And it's important that we ensure the resilient availability and functioning of that space infrastructure on which Europe's economy relies, the society relies, in our day-to-day life. And with this protection of space asset, we also would protect the assets of the two other accelerators, so the systems for crisis response and the space systems for a green future. So all three together really form an entire consistent ambition we want to bring forward. So space for a green future, the implementation of the accelerator with priority on the space for green future, as I said, provides an opportunity for reinforced European space cooperation into action. So this monitoring and acting against CO2 and active contribution to reduction. It is combining the strength and resources of ESA and in member states and the UK, including with those of other public and private partners to the benefit of Europe and its citizens at large. I would like maybe to zoom in for a moment into a related topic. As you may know, we also operate the ESA Climate Office at ECSAT that makes a strong contribution to global assessment of climate change. The Climate Office is based in ECSAT and it manages the Climate Change Initiative. This initiative draws on data from multiple satellite missions to generate global long-term observations. ESA-ECSAT will soon also be home to ESA's Climate Modeling Hub, which will support climate modeling activities and help to boost the global understanding of the changing environment. I mentioned the digital twin Earth as an example in that activity that allows really to model and predict, make forecasts and run certain scenarios to have a better assessment of what-if scenarios and impact ahead of us. Now, in all of this, we talk an end-to-end solution, but the space segment evidently is a key enabler. ESA's Earth observation satellites, they deliver an unprecedented insight into the planet's evolving environment, including issues like rising sea levels, the glacier melting, atmospheric emissions, deforestation, just to give a few examples. And those systems, those European systems, we believe today are world-leading, world-class infrastructures from space. Our effort in making our planet greener has been testified also in our participation in the COP26, which took place recently in Glasgow. And at the COP26, Eludi, our director, signed a cooperation with a water mandate to cooperate on space technologies and applications for net positive water impact. This is a great example of how ESA is using space technologies to help combat the crisis, the climate crisis. Through our applications, business applications program, we are furthermore supporting businesses within every area of the economy in driving green innovation. And areas can be transport, it can be energy, it can be health, can be many sectors of the economy where we believe green innovation can make the change. The European Space Agency's Water Scarcity Kickstarter offers support and funding to companies developing services to help alleviate water scarcity problems. And the combination of digital solutions through the digital twin, through artificial intelligence, with machine learning, with satellite connectivity, offers significant opportunities to innovate towards equitable, resilient, and clean water and sanitation access. For instance, a hybrid SATCOM terrestrial communication network can be used to link remote facilities to wider sensor networks to significantly augment water management quality, monitor its quality, and limit waste. Digital technology, including space-based digital technology, integrated into all areas of business, will result in fundamental changes to how businesses operate and how they deliver value to customers. This will increase the competitiveness of the industrial sectors and impact not only on the private, but also the public sector, including agencies and organizations. Telecommunications, together with its space component, will play a major role in the digital transition and green economy. TIA, the Directorate for Telecommunications and Integrated Applications at ESA, has issued recently a thematic call to support companies in delivering their business propositions in this domain. The call covers four themes, including vertical integration between technologies, products, services, and applications. We really offer in the program the range, the full value chain that addresses these elements, and we aim at a vertical integration to come together so that technology, product, services ultimately can help the application and utilization. Financial services are a further example of the sector that is changing and that is really impacting on the digital transformation also in space. And we aim to a more sustainable role of finance in the world economy. This is achieved through environmental risk mitigation and increasing the investments towards sustainable environmental, social, and governance options in line with the European Green Deal. European Space Agency's Space for Sustainable Financial Services Kickstart offers support and funding to companies developing these services, exploiting how space technology can support financial services, overcoming the above challenges. A word on sustainable transportation. We are providing sustainable mobility, ensuring that projects are delivering social, environmental, and climate impacts, as well as economically. This includes the intelligence use of energy, digital technology, transport infrastructure, and that applies to land. We mentioned the connected car. It applies to air, and I'll come back on an example on this in a minute, as well as sea and rail. So all vectors of transportation. So our team in TIA is active in a new proposal for green value to mobility and transportation. As mobility is at the core of many of our everyday activities, from our personal mobility to transportation and industrial logistics, and all of this is undergoing a digital transformation. So our goal in this is to support a greener and digital mobility, to help autonomous and connected transport to offer a green and sustainable solution. So rail transport, as an example, is renowned for its green and sustainable value. We work in coordination with various rail stakeholders for the improvement and digitalization of their services through space. And among them are the European Union Agency for Railways, or for example, in the UK, and the Italian Railways Infrastructure Managers. We are conducting a project called IRIS in air traffic management, which aims to make aviation safer, greener, and more efficient by developing new satellite-based air ground communication system for air traffic management. This basically will help optimized routing in flight, in transit, over Europe, it can be over the oceans. It also optimizes landing approaches at airports to, for instance, avoid circling over airports, over London and other capitals while waiting for a landing spot. So the optimized routing and planning of these transportation means, in that case, airplanes is essential. Today, this has the direct CO2 impact. And if you look at the CO2 emissions from aviation, they account to about 3 to 5% of the EU's total greenhouse emissions and more than 2% of the global emissions. So with transportations, with optimized transportations, the aviation sector contributes to 14% of the total EU transport emissions, corresponding to about 146 million tons of CO2. So air traffic management modernization is expected to help and reduce this, to deliver around 10% of fuel saving, reducing CO2 emissions in line with the Green Deal targets of climate neutrality by 2050. That is a true case where air-based transport and optimization through space means can make an impact. We believe the same is true for land, connected cars, for railways, and for sea. By using cutting-edge technology, we're helping to provide an increase in renewable energy share, and IRIS will enable air traffic management modernization target for fuel savings ranging from 5 to 10% per flight. And this is attributed now to the satellite component, the improvement thanks to the satellite component, and a target of a CO2 emissions reduction of 5 to 10% in Europe. And we believe those are significant numbers that are achievable in that domain and elsewhere. It also allows for route optimization, as I said earlier, enabling trajectory-based operations and resulting in 5% to 10% improved flight efficiency. IRIS will also enable airlines to offer better service, improved travel experience for passengers, and at a reduced cost. Market users, we are supporting the emergence of green economy in vertical markets in high economic potential in sectors as transportation and energy. We are collaborating with renewable energy utilities, manufacturing, and waste management sectors. We have supported several initiatives aimed at enabling the just transition to green and energy across business sectors and society. In that context, we recently signed a memorandum of intent with the Aberdeen Renewable Energy Group for analyzing, developing, and implementing space-enabled technology and services to support the renewable energy sector. So next to the transport sector, which we elaborated up to here, the energy sector is an important partner in our...
Ludwig, I think we need you to...
Yes, I'll try to come to the conclusion. So we're supporting over 100 companies. We support the green objectives, and I want to highlight the decarbonization effort in it. We want to accelerate our action towards the goal of the Paris Agreement. The ARTIS program helps the member states, and UK is a key partner in this initiative, together with industry, to achieve this. Let me see for sake of time, maybe as a final element here, the space for safety. We are really keeping information secure in today's interconnected world. It's increasingly important in our daily lives, and the COVID crisis, more than ever, we've seen how we rely on telecommunication networks, teleworking, social media, entertainment. We are working with the space industry in Europe to create these solutions. We're working with the public organizations and the examples already mentioned. We have a specific activity line in the program in ARTIS for space for safety and security, which really works towards these objectives. And I believe with this, I would conclude the intervention here, and it was a pleasure to present the width of activities we are conducting in the agency, and happy to work with ECSAT, through ECSAT and the UK to further advance this in the future.